Yes, what up? Mark here from Steppers Division. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make dub music. What do we need for that? What is all about? And we're going to make it the analog way, starting right now.
Invention of dub itself.
That was like a key moment.
So what is dub music? Back in the late 60s and early 70s, Jamaican sound engineers took the raw material of reggae music and transformed it to a complete new style. They've been using a lot of effects like reverbs and delays and phasers and stuff like this, and it turned to a complete crazy style, which I absolutely love, so that's why the reason why I'm going to show you how it works. So what are we gonna need? Mixer. Audio interface. Your computer. Any kind of DAW. And bunch of effects, pedals or rack units. Audio interface basics. An audio interface is a sound card. It's a device which is communicating with your computer and it's converting analog input signals like microphone or keyboard or guitar and turn it to a digital signal so your computer can read it. Those are the inputs. It also turns digital signals from your computer to audio signals called the outputs. In our case, we are using the Focusrite Scarlett 3rd generation with 8 analog inputs and 10 analog outputs. Basically, you can link more interfaces together, even if they are not digital, and the computer can see them as one device. It's a good topic for another video. If you are using a small interface with only 2 inputs and 2 outputs, dub mixing probably not going to work out. Mixer basics. A mixer works like this. A mixer is a device where you plug in several different instruments like microphones or guitars,
saxophones, or keyboards, bass, drum microphone.
Then you get the ability to set up the levels for each instrument and the mixer is going to send it out left to right to the speakers, either PA system or studio monitors. When we are using a mixer in a live situation and you got a bunch of musicians on stage, they need to hear themselves. That's why we are using the auxiliary outputs from the mixer to send them back their own signal. It's called monitoring. If you are using a mixer in a studio situation, or let's say a control room situation, and you got already some pre-recorded instruments, you don't have to send the monitor signals back to the musicians because they are not there. So this is where you can use the auxiliaries to put effects on your channels. And this is exactly our situation because we got pre-recorded instruments and we don't got anybody in studio. This is where we're going to use the interface outputs and plug it into the mixer. And the main outputs left, right from the mixer, we're going to plug in the first and second input channel of the audio interface. This is how we can record the whole thing. In our dub mixing case, we want to set the auxiliaries to post fader.
What?
What does it mean, post fader? It works like this. In our case, we got a mixer with 6 auxiliary channels. Let's say we take a microphone and plug it into the mixer. First, it hits the gain knob. Then it goes through the EQ section. And then it goes to the fader. On this point, the mixer splits the signal into 7 pieces. One goes straight to the master fader. The 6 spare signals are going to be sent into the auxiliaries and then out from the mixer separately. And those 6 signals really depend on the position of the fader. They are not working when the fader is not moving. And exactly those signals we're going to take, plug into the effects, and going to send back to the mixer again on a separate channel. So this is the basic theory. Let's plug everything together. And it sounds like this. Yeah, it was fun, but it was only one channel. Let's try it out with more channels at the same time. And now let's try it out with more auxiliary channels at the same time. You don't need a big setup to be able to do this. I will link a video in this corner so you can see how we started making our dub mixes with a small mixer and a small interface, and it was so much fun. Yes, and if you liked the video, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and see you in the next video.
Booyah!